Hey guys, what is going on? So we got some Street Fighter 2 Hyper Fighting online matches. So this is myself playing with a friend of mine. You guys may know him now. It's Gorix. We played a little bit of Virtual Fighter before and a little bit of Mortal Kombat 2. Now, during the time we played Virtual Fighter 2, Mortal Kombat 2, along with Street Fighter 2 Hyper Fighting, I was really curious in trying to see how good the netcode was in each one of these games. Now, Virtual Fighter 2, it actually seemed like it ran pretty flawless. Now, this is considering that we both actually are on the East Coast, so we have pretty good connections, so the distance between us is not as far compared from an East Coast player going to play a West Coast player. So then we hopped onto Mortal Kombat 2, and for the most part, we didn't really encounter any kind of situations where we were getting dropped frames or having some stutter in the lag or the net code or even having like some kind of input delay. And by input delay, I mean the amount of time it takes for you to press the button for the game to actually send the signal to the other person and for it to actually appear on the screen. So we didn't really encounter any input delay on both Virtual Fighter 2 and Mortal Kombat 2. So I think also one of the reasons is because maybe the games have some really good net code. I'm not really sure what type of net code is put into them. Now, however, when we went over to Street Fighter 2 Hyper Fighting, it wasn't the same experience. Like, the first time we actually started playing one evening, there was some obvious input delay that I could notice. It wasn't to the extent where it was really bad to where like you think it's unplayable, you know, your moves come out so late from when you press them. It wasn't that bad, but I actually did notice input delay just a little bit. But you know, the weird thing was there wasn't any in Mortal Kombat 2 or in Virtual Fighter 2. So, you know, I really wish they would make some of this information public on what type of net code they're using in some of these fighting games. Because for the most part, a lot of people that are into fighting games, they actually really like the GGPO net code. So, anyways, so when we played these three games, I thought they were kind of all right, and I did like going back to play these old retro games because I mostly did play Street Fighter 2 Champion Edition, and I was really hoping that Virtual Fighter 2 would get a little bit more exposure and hopefully get some more players, but it just doesn't seem like it's happening anytime soon. So, unfortunately, I have a feeling like Virtual Fighter 2 is going to be one of those rare games that just kind of, you know, just disappears into obscurity and no one really remembers it. Like, they'll just remember it to a point when they're saying, I used to play it in the arcade, but they don't want to play it online on Xbox 360. And, you know, I feel that's the same thing that happened to a lot of these old school fighting games. Like, I'm pretty sure if I picked up Sonic Fighters, even though I don't want to, and if I picked up, what is it, Fighting Vipers or something, it's the other 3D game that Sega released along with Virtual Fighter 2. So I have a feeling if I picked up those two, I believe the online would be just as inactive as these three games pretty much. Now, I want to talk about with Mortal Kombat 2, it seems like there's almost nobody on there. And, you know, the netcode seems to be all right. Like, it's pretty playable. I don't really notice anything pretty bad to it. And it just seems like a lot of these people that know these games are out, they'll just play it once for the achievements and they'll never play them again, which is a shame, you know? I mean, I like going back to playing these old retro games. I will play new games, of course, but I always actually make some time to go back and play some of the older ones because I do have a lot of fond memories of playing these old games in the arcade, and we're in a time when arcades are pretty much closing down left and right. I think there's only like one or two left in the United States, but they're pretty much only popular in Japan. But I even heard that even in Japan, they're kind of slowly dwindling down. But anyways, you know, I'm glad for the matches I could get with some of my friends in these old games because when I look back, I like to see some of these old matches that I had with friends and look back and say, yeah, those were actually some really good fun times too, because there were some old games, man. You know, it's not always about doing like 10, 15 hit combos. It's always fun to actually try out the basics, you know, and see how well you can do with a pretty pretty basic game where it's not too ridiculous in combos and all this ridiculous stuff. But anyways, that's besides the point. I think the main thing I want to get across is just saying that playing these old games is still fun, regardless of what they may lack in, I'd say, creativity or graphics compared to other games that we have now. They are still fun. But, you know, you can't really expect everyone to kind of share that same notion, because a lot of people today kind of seem to think that graphics are the main thing, you know, the main importance of a video game. But anyway, so that is all I wanted to talk about right now. So I hope you guys enjoy these retro gameplay matches. I'm out, and I'll see you guys later on.